fractions. More specifically, let's talk about fractions reducing. Because we always want them in the smallest form. I also want to talk about mixed and improper. And fractions to decimals. How do we do it? Well, let's first talk reducing. Four eighths will reduce. Now, there's more than one way to do this. We can take each number and break it into what is known as prime factoring. Right? And here's how this works. I can break 4 into 2 and 2. Those are two prime numbers. What are primes? 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17. But typically we look at a number. Can we divide it first by 2 or 3? Start easy. Alright, so with 8, I'm going to start easy. I can divide by 2. So the first factor is 2 and 4. Oh, but 2 is a prime, 4 is not. So I can break him again. So I look left to right at all the tips. Here's a tip. Here are tips. I look left to right. I have a 2. Okay. So looking at this, I need the same number of factors on top as I do bottom, so I'm going to add a 1. So I look at this. This 2 and this 2 can cancel. This 2 and this 2 can cancel, and I'm left with a 1 over 2. So 4 eighths reduces to 1 half. That is one method. Other people will do it what I call the Whittle method. I see a 2 divides out of both of those, so I'm going to divide a 2. So 4 divided by 2 is going to give me a 2. 8 divided by 2 gives me a 4. Oh, I still get even numbers. It means I can take out another 2. 2 divided by 2 gives me 1. 4 divided by 2 gives me 2. You can break numbers into prime factors, or you can whittle. If you see a number that goes into both of them, divide it out. That's the same thing that happened here. Once I broke them, I canceled them out. All right. That was reducing. Mixed and improper. Well, those two go hand in hand, because an improper fraction means the top number or the numerator is bigger than the bottom number or the denominator. This is improper. Now, how do I go from improper to mixed? I divide. I divide the bottom into the top. I do not want to go decimal. So 3 goes into 10 three times. 3 times 3 is 9. I get a remainder of 1. This is my whole number. This is my numerator. And this was my denominator, still is my denominator. So to put 10 thirds into a mixed number has a whole number and a fraction. So my whole number is 3. My numerator or top of my fraction is a 1. My bottom is still 3. So 10 thirds equals 3 1/3. This is an improper. This is a mixed. How do I go back? There's times it's easier to work with an improper versus a mixed number. Let's try a different number. I multiply the denominator to the whole number and then add the numerator. So over here, if I was going backwards, I'd go 3 times 3 is 9 plus 1. That gives me my 10. The denominator doesn't change. So to see this in a different, because we already knew what it was improper, denominator is not going to change, so I went and brought it over. But 5 times 4 is 20 plus 1 is 21. 4 fifths is the mixed, 21 fifths is the improper. All right, let's talk about fractions to decimals and decimals to fractions. Well, if I want 1/8 to become a decimal, I divide the bottom into the top. I add the decimal, I add a 0. Does 8 go into 1? No. Does 8 go into 10? Yes, once. I add the 8, I subtract. 10 minus 8 is 2. Add a 0, drop it. So, 8 goes into 20 twice. So 2 times 8 is 16. 20 minus 16 gives me a 4. It's still not even out, so I've got to add another 0 so that I can drop it. 8 goes into 40? Yes, 5 times. Now I have it dividing evenly. So 1/8 as a decimal is 0.125. Division is the key when you go from fraction to decimal. However, how do I make the decimal to a fraction? Well, I look at how many decimal places I have. I see 3, 3 numbers to the right. So that means how many zeros I have. It always has a line. And then I write the number minus the decimal over it. So if I'd had 2 decimal places, I'd put it over 100. If I had 5 decimal places, I'd put it over 100,000, 5 zeros. Now, we go back to the first thing I talked about in this video. Does it reduce? It does. I can whittle, or I can break it out into prime factoring. Let's look again at prime factoring, because that's the newest one for most people. So, I can divide that by 5. I can divide 25 by 5. I have 3 prime numbers. So I can rewrite 125 as that. Let's check here. I can do 2 and 500. I can go 5 times 100. I can go 5 times 20. 5 times 4 and 2 and 2. See, this one broke down a lot further. So I have 3 2s and 3 5s. Remember, we look at the tips. All right, this 5 cancels, this 5 cancels, this 5 cancels. When you have nothing left on top, the answer will be on 1, when you have all numbers marked. So, what I have is 1 over 2 times 2 times 2, which becomes, well, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, 1/8. Again, You could have done this by whittling. Where I seen, okay, I could take 5 out. Ooh, I can take another 5 out. You can whittle that. Or prime factoring. Either way, good method. Again, if you need more work on this, there'll be a worksheet on the web along with this. Good luck.